Hello and welcome. I'm joined today by Namita Gokhale, whose latest book, Jaipur Journals, has just hit the stores. As the name suggests, it is about Jaipur Literature Festival and what all goes around in the festival and behind the scenes. So Namita, without further ado, I think everybody was waiting for this book to be written.
Well, I don't know, because I was certainly not waiting for it. It came to me as an idea a long time ago and I resisted the idea. But once I got into it, I have to tell you that I had a lot of fun writing it.
And you're the mother of the festival, right? You have a certain degree of ownership when it comes to Jaipur Literature Festival, and then you make it into a novel. How was the experience?
Years ago, I had decided that I would write about the things I knew. I know every millimeter of the landscape in the Digi Palace. I'd say that Jaipur Literature Festival is better in my rug rug.
Right, and some of the regulars of the festival also appear in the novel, of course. I mean, Dr. Tharoor, Javed Sahab, and there are others who also have found way to the novel, but of course you're going to deny that.
I don't even know what you're talking about. My first novel, Paro, was considered a romano clef, and Delhi had people around me in Delhi society had a guessing game going on. For this guessing game continued for a few years, if not more. I think Jaipur Journals is quite different because in the eventuality that somebody may recognize themselves, it would be their own recognition.
Right, so this book was written before this year's edit of JLF.
Yes.
So, when you were in the middle of the festival, were you also trying to see your characters in real flesh and blood people? Oh, this one resembles Anirban.
Yes and no. You know, I'm sitting in the third row where I normally sit looking at the audiences, and I get a glimpse of this one or I get a glimpse of that one, yes.
What is your favorite kind of speaker or writer?
That's very difficult to say. You learn a lot about human nature from the way the writers conduct themselves. And I have to say that one of my greatest life learnings is that the greater the writer, and by greater I mean the sheer quality of writing, the greater the writer, the greater the humility, the greater the kindness, the greater the gentleness. And the more aspirational the writer, the more the anxiety, the more the vulnerability. The other thing I've realized is that writers are not performers. And many writers have a little ball of anxiety before their sessions. And after their sessions, they are just different people. I find that in myself also.
Who are the most difficult people to deal with? We're just generalizing.
No, I know generalizing. I think sometimes it's the anxieties people bring with them.
But
I know that sounds like a very diplomatic answer.
But that's all
but
right.
That is true.
I'm going to get something out of it. I'm going to be that interviewer. Minor tantrums and major tantrums. So whose tantrums are the worst to handle? The politicians or the actors or these like big fat writers, the award-winning writers?
Well, I have to say that everybody behaves like an absolute pussycat with us. And I think it's because the sheer number of celebrities evens it out. If there's one celebrity, then the stalking space is so much more. So the tantrums are the least of our problems. What our problem is, the controversies. Running the Jaipur Literature Festival is like crossing the Niagara Falls on a tightrope.
Tell us one time that you thought, oh my God, this is too much.
I think that was the year when Salman Rushdie couldn't come to the festival because there was a perceived death threat against him. And we had then decided on a video interview. And then there were these 22 worthies of the local Muslim community, including some mullahs. Many of them were very cooperative, but some of them were not. And we were asked not to have the video interview. And suddenly, the whole of the Digi Palace was full of hostile crowds.
You have worked with both the government, you know, the BJP government and the Congress government, both at the center and the state in Rajasthan. Do you feel that there is a difference in the way that they respond to the festival?
I don't think so.
So Namita Gokhale, the writer, and Namita Gokhale, the festival organizer, do they clash sometimes?
That's interesting, and I've often thought about it myself, that are these two separate people, but I don't think so.
So what about values or your priorities, for example? So as the organizer of the festival, you may be concerned about the safety of people who have come to attend the festival, but as a writer, maybe you are a little more charged about the idea of freedom of speech and expression.
This is a place for interaction, for dialogue, for debate, for arguments. I welcome arguments. I welcome conflict, as long as it is within some rules of a shared space.
Right. Have you had to referee fights behind the scenes?
Never.
Never?
Never.
Have people come back to you after the festival, maybe after a year or two or even more, that, okay, we met at JLF and now we are very good friends, or maybe we are even married?
Yes, not only married, there also seem to be a lot of ex-lovers meeting up there. Vishal Bharadwaj, this year he was with Charan Singh Pathik, who'd written the short story which he had based for his new film. And Pataka. And they had met in the lawns of the Jaipur Festival 5 years ago.
And it has also been a place of reconciliation, I would say. This happens in your book as well. But I remember the Naipaul, the famous Naipaul reconciliation with Paul Theroux.
Yes.
Up on the stage. Would you like to tell about that particular moment? And what happened before and after that?
Paul Theroux had a famous falling out with Sir Vidya many, many years ago. And it was a very, very emotive moment when Sir Vidya came with Nadira on his wheelchair, and there was this moment of reconciliation. There were many other such instances.
Like?
There have been places where political adversaries have had a quiet cup of tea and made some private peace.
When people talk about JLF, they also talk about fashion and the style statements.
I'm not so sure about that, because most of the people I know who go to the festival, they say, kuch bhi pehen lo. There may be a few first timers who think it's like Ascot or something, and they come out to make a statement. It's unlike, I went to this wonderful festival in Pakistan, where I found it absolutely amazing and quite funny also, that there was a blow-dry lady on demand. And there was a hairdresser right in the middle of the festival. In Jaipur, I completely disagree. I think, on the contrary, some really fashionable and well-dressed people normally are in their absolute grunge wear there. Except, I have to say, Shobha Day, or some people like that.
The women's side, we have our Shobha Day. What about men? The best dressed men?
Well, you know, for writers, best dressed has a very different meaning. They have to look very arty and all. I can never forget Marlon James with his Rastafarian locks. And he was walking along proudly, thinking that, you know, how cool am I, which he was. He was absolutely a magnificent looking person, but with a fashion statement in the way he dressed. And suddenly he came to the front lawn, and who was there but our very own Lakshmi.
Wow.
And I saw the look of slight astonishment on his face. I can tell you, high heels don't take you very far at the Jaipur Festival. I have indeed seen a lot of elegant women holding their high heels in their hand and going barefoot.
Thank you so much. Thanks for listening to this lovely, lovely lady speak to us about not only the book, but also the festival and what happens behind the scenes. Buy the book and read it.
and tell me who your favorite character is.